paano manggawa ng freelancer portfolio if you do not have any experience at all. It doesn't matter if halimbawa nag-work ka na sa corporate before or you have never worked at all. No matter what the situation is, this video is applicable for you. Hi, my name is Mary and I post easy to follow daily tasks that you can do to start your freelancing journey. Every day nagpo-post ako ng new videos, new tasks na pwede ninyong sundan as some sort of roadmap if you wanna transition to working from home as a freelancer, virtual assistant, paano man yung role na gusto ninyo. But this is already task number 28. At this point, it's crucial na nagawa nyo muna yung ibang mga tasks. If hindi pa kayo nakakasunod, nandito lang yung task. It's also here. Nasa Instagram ko rin siya. It's actually right here. Here, YouTube right here, and my other YouTube account here. Yesterday, yung task natin is for you guys to create social media accounts, specifically Instagram, Facebook page, at LinkedIn. Now remember, meron kang 5 services na pwedeng i-offer. Admin, creatives, tech, support, and sales. Sa portfolio mo, it should answer the question, what would my journey be like if I hire you? Resume answers the question, sino ka? Cover letter answers the question, why should we hire you? Yung portfolio mo should be focused on your client journey. Ito yung tinatawag natin client-centric. Now, for today's task, ito haba ng intro, di ba? Focus muna tayo sa admin. Ano nga ba yung pwede mong gawin as an admin support to your clients? This is the best place to showcase na marunong ka na ng Google Workspace, which pinag-aralan na natin dito sa 364-day challenge. So, I want you to create a sample work. At para hindi ka mahirapan, mag-isip ka ng industriya na familiar ka. So, whether it's your family business na hinandal mo before, ginawa mo sa corporate job mo, negosyo ng kaibigan mo, think of one industry na pwede mong pasukin. Kung nahihirapan ka, mag-comment ka dito kung ano yung experience mo and try kong sagutin mamaya. But once you have that industry in mind, all you have to do is go to Google Workspace, open Google Docs, create a short blog about the industry. Kung madalas ka nanonood ng videos ko, I'm sure familiar ka sa ChatGPT, alam mo na. A couple of reminders and references ha. Number one, please make sure that you've already downloaded Grammarly. This is important because that's for your grammar. You can go to Google, search for how to write a blog. At kung wala ka talagang maisip, how about you go back to all of your videos about the 364-day challenge and you write about your journey. Think of one topic that you can talk about for hours, something that you're really interested in. Ilagay mo siya sa Google Docs, tapos ayusin mo yung title, take a screenshot and keep it because we're going to use it sa pag-create na natin ng actual portfolio mo. Task number 1.5, open Google Sheets, research about different businesses around your area. You have to have the name, the phone number, and the website kung meron man sila. Same thing, screenshot the whole thing, keep it because we're going to use it once we start creating your portfolio. Keep in mind that we're all a work in progress, pero hindi ka nag-iisa. Document your journey, tag me, use the hashtag freelancernamethis2023. Comment any questions you guys have about working from home. Follow for more work from home chismis. Bye!